So welcome to part 3 of the series of beginner course for Bitwix Grid. And in this video I want to show you how we can make this patch we just made in part 2 a bit more fancy, bring in some modulations, bring in some audio effects and also apply some kind of small sequencing techniques inside the grid. So stay tuned and let's have some fun. So this is our patch from the last video and it's still running from back then. It's still running and yeah, what I usually do to modulate certain parameters inside this patch here is, for one, you can use modulators from the device device itself, or you can also use ADs like this one here. And I use multiple of these and I just, yeah, use them in a chain. So I trigger them one after the other. And it's possible by just disabling these pre-chords here, because we have no input from a keyboard or from a piano roll or anything like that. We just trigger the first one here with the same chord we use to trigger this main AD, which basically shapes our amplitude from the sine here. So we trigger this first AD, and then we want, when this first AD is finished, as you can see here, the point is, or the dot is following this curve, and then it falls back here to zero. So every time this hits the value of zero, we basically want to trigger the next one, the next AD. And when this AD is back to zero, we want to trigger this one. So how can we do this? It's pretty simple, actually. Or the simplest patch for this is to use a comparator. Or let's go to Logic here. And use this one here. So we go into this and we let the second input check here free, which means the input is zero. So every time this one outputs zero, which is the same value as this one, the second check, then we get the trigger signal. As you can see here, it's already signaling that we get a gate signal. So we use this for the second one. And now you can see when this one finishes its trajectory, and it's back to zero, we trigger the second AD. Sometimes it doesn't work, and the reason for that is that this AD gets re-triggered before it completely settles to zero. Okay, so you can see it works most of the times, and that's, for me, it's enough for now. So I copying this here over to these spaces here, and we do the same thing with these two and just connect these two. And now you can see when this one goes back to zero, this one gets triggered, this goes back to zero, this one gets triggered, this goes back to zero, and this one gets back to zero. And the benefit of this is that we have now some kind of a multi-stage envelope generator. It's not a real one, but it's kind of. And this also leads to all kinds of behavior, because this is not synchronized here, these ADs. So when you see you have your decay times by milliseconds, so you don't know exactly in the beat grid when this AD is finishing or goes back to zero and triggers this one. So it's completely off the grid, and when you change here the timings, you get a lot of different results for all kinds of stuff. So for instance, I use the second AD here, which has a modulator handle already integrated, which is pretty nice. And we can choose here to, yeah, modulate some stuff inside the inside our patch, right? So we can use the first one for the fold here, maybe. Or we can use this one for the skew. And maybe the last one here for shaping the melody line. But sometimes you exactly want to have this synchronized to some kind of grid, okay? And you can do that. All you have to do is basically use a clock quantize here. And a clock quantize takes two inputs. At first it takes our signal, and this signal gets delayed until something happens on the gates or pulse or quantize signal or the clock signal. So we get out of this here into the second AD, and we have to deliver one clock signal. And for the clock signal, we just use one simple gates module here. Just activate all bars and go into here. Okay, now we can see what's happening when we just click on this clock quantize here. We see when our AD, first AD, goes back to zero, it triggers, and then the clock in here, and then we have the output. And you can see the output is delayed until one of these, yeah, quantized signals happening. Okay, so this is basically off the grid. Then we have our grid here, our grid signal, or our beat synchronization signal, and this one is gets delayed until, yeah, or is synchronized to this signal. So we can increase the signal here by to go to 16 maybe. So we have basically divided our bar into 16 triggers. I'm gonna click here on this again. You can see we have more possibilities now where this signal can be triggered within our grid. So, and when we just go back here to 4 maybe, you can see the gaps here are much farther apart. And you can see this signal here gets delayed, this one gets delayed a bit, this one is delayed. So with this, basically with this small setup here, with this clock quantize module, you can delay certain signals until we have a clock signal happening. So, and we have to do this here, of course, for all the rest of the ADs too. Put this in here. Bam, 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 bam. And we need, of course, also a synchronization signal here on these two. And now we have a synchronized multi-stage envelope generator in the grid. And you not only can use this inside of ambient patches, you can also use this, of course, for mid-range bases, which is pretty nice. And I also did a lot of presets for Bitwig with this kind of setup already. And it's fun to use, it's fun to do, and it's easy to do. It's not that complicated, right? You can also change here the synchronization pulse or the clock signal pretty easily. You can also go up to 16 here. And also, if you want to bring in swing, you can do this by using a phase in and maybe use one of the new pinch, one of this new module pinch here, recently added in 3.3, and just, yeah, can see the signal is more groovy now, to say it that way. Okay, so this is also possible, but for now that's it basically. So you can use this here. This one gets triggered, then it gets triggered when this is at zero, this gets triggered when this is at zero, and this one gets re-triggered when this one is at zero, and everything is synchronized to this gates module. So pretty easy setup and fun to use. So now that we have these modulations in place, we probably want to include some kind of audio effects in our patch. And we have already some audio effects here on the global FX channel with the reverb and the delay. But sometimes you want to have just audio effects or different audio effects on different paths inside your patch. And that's not really possible. There's no, yeah, output or yeah, for path and input or audio input and output for the patch itself. It's only a global output and a global input. There is this trick that you can, yeah, go out with the DC offset device inside the NodeFX channel here. I want to show you this real quick. I created also a preset for that, which is called audio grid out. And all we have to do now is we can use, for instance, Let's use this audio output here. And we need a stereo split. And the stereo split gives us the signal from the left and the right channel if we have a stereo signal. And then we need a modulator out here for the left channel. And we need a modulator out for the right channel. And now we modulate here the left. And we modulate the right. Okay, and this gives us basically an audio signal here in the FX channel. You can see here already the metering happening or giving us some signals. And when we exchange this here, you can see there's a audio FX layer. We have a left channel and a right channel, and we have in there just a DC offset and receiving the, the signals from within the grid, right? And now we can apply here to the left and the right channel, for instance, some kind of reverb. Okay. And then we can go here with the audio chain input. We can just use the output of this reverb and bring it back in, basically. So now we need a mixer. And the mixer gives us the output here, or the tri signal. And we have the wet signal from our reverb here. Maybe delete here the reverb on the global signal. So we basically have just here a tri signal. Then we use this tri signal, go into the stereo splitter, into these modulators, output, how is it called? Modulator outs, and these modulating basically our grid audio out left and right channel and generating an audio signal, go into the reverb here, and then the reverb goes back into here via the audio sidechain into the second channel and then back out to our global output. So a lot of routing just for a reverb, or maybe sometimes you want to have exactly that because you have some kind of special VST you want to use inside the grid, so you can use this. You don't need to have here left and right channel separately, but DC offset device, you can just use a DC offset and just modulate this if you have a mono signal. So this is just a setup here I made for myself when I want to use this kind of workflow. And it's also for free available in my GitHub account, which is linked below in the description, of course. And yeah, that's one way of integrating some kind of external effects. And we also can use effects inside the grid by creating audio effects. And for instance here, I want to show you how you can create a reverb, which is also pretty easy. So we need also a stereo splitter, because I like to do it this way. And also a merger here, which brings these signals back together. And then I'm using maybe a delay. Maybe go with this one here and switch it to 2 milliseconds. Go into the left. Use the second one, go into the right. Use maybe different timings. And then we can amplify here the the feedback, which gives us some kind of feedback, of course. Then we go here into the third channel, and we need of course a tri signal. It sounds more like a delay, because it isn't delay. But we can use multiple of these delays here. Make the signal more dense. Or diffuse the signal. Maybe use even more. We can hear it starts to sound more like a reverb, right? All you have to do now is probably to modulate the pitch of these mod delays. Because now they sound a bit too metallic. So this way you can simulate some kind of reverb. What's also possible is to use just the all pass devices. Which two kind of the same thing. Maybe use multiple here, multiple all pass devices. Just connect these together. Which also sounds like a reverb. So now we have an external reverb integrated here with the grid audio out in the NodeFX channel. And we have a global reverb, a delay. And we created a small, simple reverb here just with the all-pass devices, which is also possible. What we also can create is some kind of phasing effect, and it's also easy to do in the grid. All we need to do is, split one audio path into two paths. And we use a mod delay here. Go into the mod delay, and then we have to mix these signals together. Maybe we can use here an mixer again and go in here. So now we have to try signal and the mod delay signal. And then we go back to this knob here. Choose a pretty short delay time, and then we increase here the feedback. And you can modulate just this knob here if you want to have some kind of phasing effect, or you use the input here for the mod delay. And the delay modulation amount is basically this knob, so you can modulate this knob via some kind of signal, and we can probably use the LFO, for instance. That's probably too slow. Let's use the second one here, just to show you how it sounds. So this can also bring in a lot of interesting variety to the sound, just using the mod delay as a phaser. And you don't need to modulate, you can also just use here this in this setup and maybe find a sweet spot. Or maybe use more of these mod delays. Okay, so this is basically a small, simple phaser setup in the grid. You don't need external effects for this. And I just wanted to show you this, so you don't need to actually use here a grid audio out, just use a phaser or a reverb. You can just build this for yourself inside the grid. You also don't need to use pretty complex patches or make this as big as possible. Sometimes simple effects are just enough, and when you add a lot of different effects inside the grid and modulations, the sound will still sound fine, and it's enough in most cases. Okay, so now we have solutions for modulations in the grid. A pretty unique solution with the ADs, or the chaining of these ADs, and I showed you how you can implement certain audio FX from the outside, and how you can create reverb and phaser inside the grid pretty easily. And I wanted to also show you how you can sequence stuff in the grid, or how I do it. So my easiest setup for this is to use an LFO. So for instance, we have this sound here running, and it's playing all the time at the same volume. So what I do usually is to take the LFO, go to bar, and then we go up to 32 bars. So this is basically a slow ramp, as you can see on the signal out, a slow ramp, slowly going down and slowly going up. And I use this to sequence stuff. So for instance, we can bring here the volume of all these lines down, and say just we want to have a 32 bar iteration of the tri signal. Okay, so we bring in the tri signal here in, maybe go to 75. Okay, so now you can basically watch the signal here on the on this inspector for the LFO, and you can see it brings slowly in our tri melody line. And we can use this also here for the reverb, maybe 75, but choose a different timing. So it's a polymeter, right? I learned it's not polyrhythms, it's a polymeter. So we have basically the same beat, but we have different timings. And sometimes when you have a different melody, or I use this when I use basically when I combine multiple patches. So I have one patch running, blended in, and then the other patch is basically quiet. And then the other one is blended in, and the other one goes quiet, okay? So you can do this by basically changing here the phase, just turning this 180 degrees. So it's basically completely the opposite. So you can maybe fade this in, or go to zero, and then fade this out. Go back to minus one, okay. So now when this one is blended in, this one is quiet, and vice versa. So this is also something I use a lot when I have, like I said, multiple patches playing. I want to just always have just one patch playing and the other one is quiet, and then just exchange it slowly over time. And because it's a sine shape here, we have a slowly transitioning between these two states. So this is something I use a lot. The LFOs sadly go only up to 32 bars. But when you want to make these sequences a bit longer, then there's also a trick for that. Of course, there's always a trick for all problems inside the grid. So maybe we take here an oscilloscope to show what's going on. And go to fast here, or maybe slow. And you can see you're slowly rising, right? And then maybe I'd turn this down here, maybe to just one bar or two bars. Okay, and then we can use a scaler, connect this here to the phase input, and maybe does all the way up. And we need a phase input here, which is our phase signal from the transport. And you can see now we can change a bit here the speed of the LFO, even though it's still at 2 bars, right? And I think this is the default. No. Something like this should be the default. Yeah, that's the default. And when you go up here to maybe 32 bars, and then you go also all the way up to 32 bars, it should be something like 64 bars, I think. I guess so. So with this trick, you can make these 32 bars even longer if you want. You can also go all the way up to maybe 60 or something like this, or 99. So you can make this pretty long if you want, just by phase modulating here the LFO with the scalar and the phase input, or even just generate your own phase signal. It's also possible. So with these things, you can make also pretty long evolving pads or sounds happening if you're not happy with the 32 bar limits here, basically. Okay, so this is one solution for that. There's also maybe if you want to sequence stuff more directly, you can of course use the merge module. So you can bring in your multiple LFOs maybe, and then just switch between these two. This is also something you can use. But I mean, there are infinite solutions to everything. I mean, it's impossible to list them all. But this is what I use most of the times to sequence stuff. I use the merge module to switch between inputs, or use LFOs to fade in or in and out sounds with a mixer or with a volume knob. So I think that's enough for just one video. So there will maybe a fourth video in the series where I create a patch from scratch and talk over it, talk what I just did or what I want to do, and to basically reiterate or resume everything together in one video and to make the knowledge persistent, if this makes sense. Okay. So yeah, I want to close down this video. I hope you learned something in today's video. There will be a lot of more videos like this, and I also plan to do more normal Bitwig stuff, bringing in more knowledge and more ideas to the people. And yeah, that's basically it. So thanks for watching. If you have some questions, then please ask it in the comments. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't so. Also, please subscribe to Patreon or become a member here on YouTube. It pretty much helps a lot because that's what I do all day for a living, basically doing tutorials, making sounds and so on. So it helps a lot, keeping me alive. Also like the video if you liked it, and if you don't like it, then leave a dislike, of course. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.